Eternal God, most gracious Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your blessings. We thank you for your mercies. And most of all, Lord, we thank you for life. We ask you, dear Father in heaven, to guide and to keep us. And to lead us, O God, as we come forth over these airwaves with your word of encouragement and inspiration. Bless your people everywhere, God. And help us all, O God in heaven, to continue to love you, worship you, and adore you. And let us all do this in spirit and in truth, O God, as you allow us to use our spiritual gifts that you have given unto us. In Jesus' name, we ask you, God, to bless this program, that it will benefit to someone's heart. It will be a blessing, O God. And it will be said that it was good for us. Worship the Lord tonight. Worship Him in spirit and in truth. Yes. How beautiful it is to praise the Lord in songs and instruments. It's so beautiful to praise the Lord with your gifts of music, with the instruments that the Lord had blessed us with. And you know, it's such a good thing to praise the Lord and know that, you know, you end up without a hangover. You end up feeling good, feeling revived, feeling refreshed when you praise God in spirit, when you praise Him truthfully and be righteous. Oh God, have mercy. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. To all our listeners everywhere, near and far, greetings from the Gosperad Productions, coming to you live on a Saturday night. And your host is none other than Pastor Green. And to our new listeners tonight, the number in studio is 347-663-8638. And the number on your telephone, if you want to listen on your telephone, is 213-493-0146. Telephone, on your telephone, the one on your hip, the one in your pocketbook, 213-493-0146. And remember, it's your life, your salvation, and your choice. And we are just streaming live for Jesus tonight on the web, westindianpeople.com. Tune in, listen in, and be blessed. Because only what you do for Christ will last. Again, this is the Gospel Ride and live on a Saturday night. Let's take a moment from your busy time and just praise the Lord a little bit. Tell him all about yourself. Tell him all about your trouble. Yes, call on Jesus tonight. Just tell him all about you. Just tell him, you know, what you need from him, what all that you have been through, and all that, you know, you need to know about him. Say, Lord, I want to know more about you. Yes. The number one Jesus.
There is none like you.
None like him.
No one else can touch my heart like you do. I can search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. Well, help me sing it. There is none like you.
And good night to Cousin Will and his wife.
Eternity long.
Just keep on praying and hold on to God's unchanging hands.
Like you.
007, Mr. 007 and First Lady 7. Pleasant good evening to you.
And the healing comes from your head.
DJ Vibe, First Lady Vibe. There is none like you, Lord.
No one else can touch me.
Greetings going out to Azette. Lucia, little Chelsea.
Dickiness
Green.
And find there is none like you.
There is none like the Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, yes. It's none like you, God. None like you. And all we have to do is continue to praise the Lord and give him thanks and bless his name because he's forevermore. See, we gotta remember one thing, that we from dust we came and from dust we shall return.
Yes. I've got to be in agreement with Bishop Smith.
Don't matter what we accumulate, don't matter how much we have, don't matter how cute we think we are, don't matter how we think we own things. Just remember that we are owned by the Lord. Just remember, you are not here for too long. In the twinkling of an eye, we shall be gone. So don't hold on to too much of this earthly thing. But hold on to the Lord and change in Him. To all our true believing listeners, spread this word. We are all dust. So it's time to serve the Lord. Come before His presence with some singing. Come with some praise. To all the Powell family here and over there in London. Greetings coming to you from the Gospel Ride. Choice Radio 92.9 FM. Right here in New York City. Choice Radio thanking the gospel everywhere.
What? foreign land or a local land, we shall return, and some preacher or rabbi somewhere will commit our bodies, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. So I call them to repent, I call them to look before God, because one day we shall return. What is man? Man a dust, man a dust, man a dust, man a dust. Humble yourself, brother. Hear me, hear me. You listen to me now. You better remember that there is a God who shall call all of us, and we shall stand before him. Oh, my friend, it doesn't matter what you own or how much money you have. We are just us. So as you listen, repent and prepare yourself for Almighty God. For one day, God, the Almighty One, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning, hallelujah, and the end, shall call us to repentance. And the Bible says, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Man, we are just us. Whether you are male man or female man, we are just us, because God created man from the dust. He created them male and female, and man become a living soul.
Yes, man become a living soul. Yes, we are all just dust in the sight of the Lord. We are created from dust, and from dust to dust we shall return. So let's ask someone to pray for us, pray with us, and let's all pray together, because all we can do is pray and ask God to make us worthy. Yeah, just ask someone to pray. You know, prayer changes things, and in everything we should give God thanks. Because everything that is made by him was well made, beautifully made, well organized, and everything was put in its proper perspective. When we look back and see how much we have destroyed the things that God had created, it's time for us to, you know, just give God praise and glory and honor and just ask for forgiveness. God, we have destroyed so much of what the Lord had created so beautifully, so wonderfully made. Oh, hallelujah. Time to give God some praise. Give him some glory in everything. Give him glory. Give him praise.
This peace, yeah, that I have. Oh, oh, oh.
This request is coming forward. Pastor's Green. Yes, his peace is all around. Don't forget.
Tomorrow, make no promise to no one.
the Lord while you can find him. Because tomorrow wasn't promised to none of us. FM. Just hold on, hold on, hold on. It is a blessed moment to come in this place to talk about Jesus, to listen to the songs of glory, to play the songs that are written by people and sung by people who at one time or another had encountered something in their lives that want them to change and to follow Christ. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Wait, I say, on the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I?
To all our West Indian listeners tonight in the West Indies, Christ is the answer. To everyone who's listening right now, Christ is the answer. No matter how hard your burden or how much it is, Christ is the answer.
Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. It shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Wait patiently on the Lord.
Against me,
Oh yes. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. What shall you render unto the Lord? What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits? Should I give, or should we give our earnings? Should we give our worldly possession? Or should we just give him ourselves? It's time for us to give ourselves to the Lord. Because if we don't know what to do with ourselves, the Lord knows what to do with it. He will mold us and make us and shape us into what he wants us to be molded and shaped in. So we can be worthy to call upon his name and to spread his gospel and to tell others how good he has been to us. It's time for us to give not only our tithes and offering in the heart and the building, which is called a church, but it's time to give ourselves. We need to give ourselves to the Lord because the Lord needs us. He needs us to do his work. He needs us to do his will. He needs us in every capacity that we could think of to tell others of his goodness and to tell others of his mercies, especially those of us who had been through the storms, been through the warfares of life, been in places where if it wasn't for the mercies of God, we would never come out unscathed. Some of us have done things that we had no point of return, but being of the mercies of God that it came through, brought us through. Oh, have mercy, Lord. Some of us used to prepare for a good time on a Sunday night out of the Lord Jesus Christ. But thank God, now that we have changed our course of direction and decide to serve him, let us serve him wholeheartedly. Because in the end, only what we do for Christ will last. Everything else we will forget about. Or what we do for someone or what they do for us, we forget. But there's a song that says, I will never forget how he brought me out. I'll never forget how he saved me. I want to give him thanks all the day long. Jeremiah put it rightly, said, like fire shut up in his bone. See, when the Lord wants us to, or when the Lord ordained it so we have to come out of what we are into, and go and come into what he wants us into. When the time comes, we can't stand our heel. We can't stay away. We can't run away. We have to just stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Oh my God, hallelujah, Lord. When the time comes for us to witness for the Lord. Oh, taste and see how good it is to serve God. The woman at the well, she was so overwhelmed, she went back, run back to her village, and she said, come see a man that tells me all about me. Come see a man that knows everything and can do everything. We read in his word, he turned water into wine, he made the blind man see, the lame walk. Have mercy, God. But a lot of us today are still lame out of the Spirit of God. We are still blinded to the word of God. We are still deaf to the word of God. We are not giving God his dues, his rightful dues. But thanks be to God for those who make up their mind to serve him and to do what needs to be done for the Lord. To God be the glory, hallelujah, great things he has done, will do, and still doing, and going to do. Because in everything, he's able to do then take care of it. Our soul should be crying out. We should be giving God our all, give him ourselves. Give him everything that needs to be given to him. God is a good God. Let's give ourselves to the Lord. Let's give away ourselves to the Lord.
The earth who are longing and looking for you. Come on, say it. I give myself. You're saying, God, here I am. I withhold nothing. I give you my everything. I give myself. So you. I love not my life even unto death. I say, I give myself.
Let us give him everything tonight.
You might not even know what that completely means, but God's looking for a generation. I give myself.
Just lift your hand and give him everything tonight. Praise him.
Come on, lift your voice just one more time and say it. I give myself away.
Let us give ourselves away that he can break our chains tonight. Say yes to his word. Say yes to him right now.
Yes, Lord, yes. We say yes.
Even before you ask us the question, God. Yes. This is the word of agreement between heaven and earth. Oh, yes, Lord, yes. Come on over this room from your heart. We say yes. Say we say yes. Oh God, we say yes. 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 Come on, there's a surrender happening in this room. We say yes. We submit to you, yes. We belong to you, yes. Yes, Lord.
For those that are sick right now, say yes to the Lord. Give him yourself. He can heal a broken heart. He can heal a sick body. All you have to do is say yes to him. Yes to your will and to your way, Lord. For those who need a job right now, God has everything. Christ can make it possible where it looks impossible right now, where job is concerned. Christ Jesus is the only one that had died and come back from the dead. His tomb is empty. So there's nothing that he can't give us right now. There's nothing that he can't do right now for us. If it's hardship, if it's the need of a job, it's in sickness, give it to him right now. Oh yes, Lord. Say yes to the Lord right now. Yes. Say yes to the Lord right now.
Lord, hear the cries of our generation. Hear the cry of our generation. Our word of obedience is yes. Our word of worship is yes.
listen, make up our mind to give ourselves away to Christ Jesus, because we have heard it over Choice Radio. Yes. Give myself to you, Lord.
My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give my
in your sick state, bring yourself and give it to the Lord. And He will fix it for you. He will fix it how He wants to. Yes, let us take courage from the woman with issue of blood.
My life is not my own.
That been everywhere.
My own.
But finally she came to Jesus and said, Jesus, I just want to give myself to you. Just by touching the hem of your garment, Lord. So I may, can be made whole. Oh, hallelujah. She didn't have no doubt in her heart. Or she said, I just want to. Lord, when we give ourselves away to you, Lord, when we do that, Lord, we just want you to fix it for us, Lord. We don't want you to fix it, Lord. We don't want you to repair it, Lord. You see, Lord, when we see you, Lord, we see the shoemaker, we see the heart fixer, the doctor that do the heart surgeon, Lord, God in heaven. We see operating table, Lord, and we see you standing there.
I give myself.
We see the classroom, God, and we see you standing there as a teacher to teach us, Lord.
I give myself.
Oh, hallelujah, Lord. When we go to the job and the job has so much problem, so much hardship, God, and we see you, Lord, and our burdens become light. And we want to thank you, Lord, because we take no thought for tomorrow, but let's keep our eyes on Jesus. Keep our thoughts in Him. There's a song that said, you know, when I look back and I wonder how I got over. Today is a day of salvation and rejoicing. Look back and say, I wonder how I got over. But when you look back, I want you to just make your imagination go to the sands of the seashore where you saw the footprint in the sand. Hallelujah, Lord. And you know you didn't walk that way. You didn't come that way. But just remember, when the Lord took you, when the Lord carried you, His prints was in the sand. Ours was nowhere to be found. But we were riding on His grace and His mercies. Yes, Lord, we thank you.
Can you, oh God, give myself.
I give myself away, Lord. Just lift your hands right now and just tell the Lord, I give myself to you right now, Lord. Although I have no job right now, God, I just give myself to you. You will provide for me and you will find a job, God. And if there's a job that I'm on that's giving me problem, Lord, I know you will fix it. You will smooth it out for me, Lord. Just give it to the Lord. Take it to him right now. Just tell him all about you. Tell him all about your troubles right now. Heavenly Father, most gracious God, we come to you as humble as we know how. We come to you, God, calling on your holy and matchless name. For you, asking you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, just to touch the sick right now. Whatever sickness it is, God, we know you can heal it. We know you can destroy it, God, and send it back to the pits of hell where it belongs, oh Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord, for who you are. We thank you that you're a great God and you can do all things but fail. Provide for your people right now, God, that trust you. Lord, we just thank you that you're a God who make it possible for even those who do not believe in you, who do not worship you, God. You provide for them anyway, as you provide for the birds of the air. Much more, God, your people that trust and believe and pray to you and worship you, God. We know you can come true for them, God, but we just, oh God, ask you to help them, to help us all to connect to you in spirit and in truth. And let righteousness prevail, O God in heaven.
So God, take my heart.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your gracious mercies towards us, O God. We thank you, Lord, for all that you have done. We thank you for all that you will do, O God in heaven. We thank you, God, for our grandparents, our parents who we watch them praise you. We watch them, oh God, glorify your name. And they taught it to us, God. And we want to help us, oh God, to keep that tradition going, Lord. That as we come to our crossroads in life, God, we will give ourselves away to you, God, that you can use us as you see fit, Heavenly Father. Oh God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for who you are. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercies, God. And as you look beyond our faults, Lord, and see our needs, we ask you, Lord, to accept us. Filthy rags as we are, oh God in heaven, damaged as we may be, with all our faults, with all our needs, with all our despair, with all our sickness, oh Lord in heaven, with all our grief and all our burdens, Lord, we come to you, humble as we know how. And ask you, Lord, in heaven, just to fix it for us, Lord. Fix it for your people right now. Fix it, oh God. Because to you we belong, oh God, in heaven. Help us to give ourselves totally to you, oh God. Without looking back, without, oh God, trying to see anything behind us, God. But the only thing behind us we should see, God, is to reach out and, oh God, lend a helping hand for those who want to come forward out of their darkness, out of their sins, and into your grace. Thank you, Lord, for all your goodness. Thank you for all your mercy. Thank you for your graciousness towards us, oh God, in heaven. Lord, have mercy on us. Our life is not our own, God, and we just thank you that your word is there to guide us. Your word is there to remind us. Help us, Heavenly Father. Where things need to be mended, oh God, in our world, in our lives, in our homes, in our jobs, God, we ask you to mend it for us. Where rebuilding is needed, God, We ask you to build for us, O God in heaven. Where strength is needed, Lord, we ask you to strengthen us. Father, most of all, we thank you for this conduit, God, that is called by the name Choice Radio. Father God, we just thank you. Most of all, God, I just thank you that I'm a part of this, oh God in heaven. I just want you, Lord, to strengthen each and every one that come through these airwaves with your word and your encouragement to your people. Oh, hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Lord, we just thank you. We worship you, God. We praise your name. We give you thanks, Lord. Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord.
What would happen?
We thank you.
If a generation embraced this.
We thank you, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to touch our generation, God. Touch this younger generation, God. Our young children, our young people, oh God, wherever they might be at this time. Lord, if there is any virtue right now in those who are heading to their various places of partying tonight, God, we just ask you, Lord, just to let a little seed just linger on in their hearts right now, Lord. That when they come back from where they went, God, they will give you thanks for taking them back home safely. And in giving you thanks, Lord, we just ask you to work on them a little bit, Lord. And Lord, remind them of who you are. Remind them of your love for them, O God in heaven. And your sacrifice of life. O Lord, help them to give themselves to you, O God. And never return, O God in heaven, to the places that they have been. Last night, the day before, or any time at all, O God. But to go forward in your grace and your mercies. Thank you, Lord, for who you are. Thank you, dear God. Thank you for families. Thank you, Lord. Keep the family together, Lord. Each and every one, ours and theirs, O God in heaven. Help us all to give ourselves away to you, Lord. That as we give ourselves to you, we will be, oh God, sanctified by your grace, sanctified by you, God, blessed by you, turned around. Lord, we thank you. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you that you have allowed us to make a U-turn. So, Lord, we pray the same for our fellow men. We pray that, oh God, for our brothers and sisters, that they too will make a U-turn in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we ask you right now, God, to touch the sick families of ours and the sick families of everywhere, oh God, in heaven. Those we know and those we don't know, God. We know that you are a God who's everywhere at the same time. And we just pray that you will hear my humble prayer, God. Hear our humble prayer, O Lord in heaven. Where we need to be spiritually repaired, Lord. We also ask God to repair us. Oh God, we know that you are able to fix us up and straighten us out, O God, and set us up financially, God, that we won't have to worry about not serving you because of finances, God. But Lord, we know that you're able to do all things. Make it possible for your ministry to go forward, God. Without the grumbling and the mumbling about finances. Lord, we know you can provide. Help, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for all those who put together and all those who had a hand in making this radio station possible, God. Survival is in your hand, God, and we know you will do it for us, oh God, in heaven. Continuation is in your hand, Lord. And we know you're able to let it happen, God. Love is in your hand, Lord, and we know you can spread it all about, oh God, in heaven. So your word will go forth. And your people will be blessed. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen. And amen. Amen. Give God some praise. Wherever you are. Give him some glory wherever you are. He's worthy to be praised. In 2 Peter chapter 2. For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down into hell and delivered them into chains of darkness. Yes, Lord, to be reserved unto judgment. Lord, we just thank you. Thank you, Lord. Choice Rainy on the air.
Good evening, Pastor. And I said, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, God, I thank you.
Yes, we give God thanks.
Oh, you know. Tonight you said every prayer, everything I needed to hear.
Oh, thank God.
And I give God thanks and praise for you tonight.
Only God,
may God,
only God
bless you and forever give you the strength and the mind to continue. Keep you in your right mind to do the things yes. that you're doing. And God bless you.
I thank you.
Thank you.
To God be the glory.
Thanks. Good night.
Good night. To God be the glory, great things he had done. We thank God for all his blessings and his mercies. God is a good God. If he spared not the angels, that's sin. Why do we think that if we sin, he will spare us if we don't repent of our sins? We will be cast away into hell, waiting for judgment. But what I want to focus on here tonight, when we are cast down into hell and delivered, he delivered them into the chains of darkness. In every one of us tonight, right now, in the sound of my voice, there is a chain that is holding something on us, or holding us to something. We want to ask God to give us the strength through prayer to break that chain tonight. We need the Lord to break that chain for us, but we have to call on him. Don't let him cast us into the darkness of sin and hell. Because once we are there, we will be chained. Oh my God, have mercy, Lord. If we go somewhere and we come back home, the first thing we do, we turn on the lights. If we don't have a light to turn on, we have big problems. Because we know there is no current there. In our lives, there will be no spirit there to turn on the spiritual lights in our soul. Just like how we need to turn the light switch on and get the light from the city or wherever it comes from, for us to see around the house, around the yard, and to see what we want to do. Let us ask the Lord to break the chain of darkness right now in our lives, that we will come forward to the throne of grace before it's too late and be cast away. There is a chain that needs to be broken right now. For some, it's the chain of money. Although we say we are Christians, but we are not true Christians. So we are chained to our money. We are chained to buildings. We are chained to real estate. We are chained to everything else but except the word of God. And except we are not chained to God himself. We need to break the chain. Yes, we need to have things, but we not don't need to make things become us. We need to make the Holy Spirit come become us. Have mercy, Lord. There's a chain holding us in one way or the other. And if we look diligently around ourselves and in our lives, we will see that chain just as plain as we see our in the middle of our hands or look at our feet. We will see that there's a chain holding us to something. And it's not the chain that is chaining us to the Holy Spirit. But every chain that is holding us that is unworthy of the worship and of the Spirit of God, we need to ask the Lord right now to break it. We need to break those chains right now. We need to do away with them chains right now. And let's not try to do it ourselves because we only make a mess of it. Ask the Lord to do it for us. Do it for me, Lord, one more time. Just ask him that. Do it one more time for me, Lord. Because the angels that at one time was righteous, one time that was good, and you did not spare them, Lord, that sin, but you cast them down into hell. Let us all ask the Lord right now to break the chain that is holding us hostage from righteousness, from serving him, from coming into his presence with thanksgiving, from knowing that he is God and he that had made us. Let us ask the Lord to break that chain that is blocking our vision, that chain of darkness that is covering our sight, our spiritual sight. There's a chain that needs to be broken right this moment. And once it's broken, we will be set free, let loose, turn loose, and just want to praise God, just want to shout, just want to give him glory, just want to jump, run, hug, and shout, and love everybody, and just do the will of the Lord and say, yes, Lord, I thank you for who you are. Thank you for saving grace. Thank you, Lord, for doing it for me one more time. For those who like to love to go to church, for all the go to church people, I want you all to pay special attention to the chains of darkness that lead you to go to church and leave the same way you went in. And when the altar call comes around for one to step up and say, yes, Lord, to your will and to your way, heads start to turn all around, get fidgety, looking down, looking up, closing eyes and all kind of stuff. I know what it's like when I used to do the same thing. But glory be to God. I decided to follow Jesus. I decided to turn loose the things that was chaining me to the darkness, spiritual darkness, and break it loose and turn into spiritual light. Because the light of the world is Jesus. Let us come before his presence with singing, joyful, joyful. Oh, joyful is it to serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us break the chain tonight.
Let us break the chain tonight, the chain of darkness. Yes, it's time for those who taking them nap, their little nap before party time. It's almost time to wake up, get dressed, put on your makeup, get your sporting goods together, put it on, and gather with all my children on the edge of tonight as the world turns, going into another world on the edge of night. But be careful, you fall over the edge of night. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Try to ask the Lord to break that. If you are listening to me right now, and you know what you're fit to do later on, ask the Lord to break that chain for you right now. If you know some, if someone is listening, you know someone who is not going to do the right thing tonight, so they can be prepared for worship, true worship, in the morning. Get on the old ring-a-ding dial and dial them and say, you know what? Rethink your position. Rethink your strategy and, you know, change your mind. And remind them of one good thing that the Lord allows. Because if they go out there and they miss the place they want to go and make a U-turn, they're subject to get a ticket and a fine by the city. But if they make a U-turn for Jesus right now, there's no charge, no penalty, no repercussion, and no chance of getting into an accident. But let's hold on to God's unchanging hand. Break the chain of darkness right now in the name of Jesus. Call on him while he's near, because only what we do for Christ will last. I can't say that enough. And the motto here at Choice Radio is your life, your salvation, and your choice. At one time, I didn't know it was my life. I know it was my life, but I didn't know it was my salvation I'm throwing away and the choice I have to make. And I'm intriguing and asking right now for those who know someone who not making the right choice. Call them up. Tell them to make a choice for Jesus right now. There's a song that says, softly and tenderly, Jesus is waiting. He's calling for you and for me. Come home. Ye who are weary, come home. And it's so sad that we don't know that we are weary. We don't know that we are going down the slippery slope. Because things look so nice. We smell so sweet. And we look so good. Going to serve the angel of darkness. You know, I leave the station when my time is up. And on my way home, at a certain place where I reach on my way, there's about 5 different party spots. Opposite each side on the street. And if you see, if someone, you know, just see the amount of half-naked young women, young girls, going to jig and weave. And Lord have mercy, I don't want to speculate, but you know, I could take a chance by saying somebody in that group with that dress way up to their navel is going to somebody's church tomorrow. And act as if they're worshiping and praising God. Oh, hallelujah. They're not praising God. They're still praising who they went to worship last night. And that goes for the men too. But you know what? The word is going out every single day. Every waking moment, the word of the Lord is going forth. And the sad thing about it, people are not paying attention. But God bless the faithful few that is holding on to the Lord's unchanging hand. That they know that they are all their children for God. And as the world turns, they are in the middle with Christ. And as they prepare to go to another world of paradise, and they see the edge of night, they thank God that they are not on the edge. Lord, have mercy. Go into another world. To God be the glory, great things He has done. Thank Him for who He is. Thank Him for what He has done for us. Thank Him for the remembrance or the reminder on Calvary's cross. Lord, have mercy, Lord. You know, sometimes I play the song which is somebody's song with a catching fire for the Lord. It's not too late to call someone you know and tell them to slow down. Like we used to say back home, haul and pull up. Change your direction, make a U-turn for the Lord right now. God allows U-turn. And in everything, you will be able to give Him thanks for His saving grace and turning your life around. You're listening to Choice Radio 92.9 FM. And this is a gospel ride coming to your live and your house, Pastor Green. You can tune in on the web. Choice Radio Ministries or westindianpeople.com. You can listen on your telephone if you don't have a way of getting it otherwise. Any phone you have, 213-493-0146, 213-493-0146. And if you care to share a word in studios, the number is 347-663-8638. And remember, it's our life, it's our salvation, and it's our choice. But it all comes down to your life, your salvation, and your choice. To God be the glory. Let's break the chain of darkness tonight.
There is power
in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
2 Peter 2 and 4. Cast them into hell and deliver them into the chains of darkness. We want to break the chains of darkness tonight. Break every chain. Hallelujah, Lord. Let us break every chain tonight that is keeping us locked out of the Spirit of God.
Come on, you declare it.
There is power.
There is power.
Yes, you want to break every chain tonight.
We know where it is to break every chain.
Power in the name of Jesus to break all them chains right now.
Break every chain. There's an
arm. The power of sickness. Have no power over the spiritual power of God.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain.
There's an army.
There's an army of the Lord ready to break all the chains right now. Yes, you hear the chains falling. Like when Paul and Silas prayed, the chains fell from their feet. The locks fell off the door. You can hear the chains falling if you pray hard enough. You can hear all the chains falling if you pray hard enough and give God praise, give Him glory. Everything will be all right when you pray. Give God glory. All my help comes from the Lord to break those chains of darkness. Underneath the blood, the devil can't do us no harm. Power of darkness have no harm, no strength over us. Oh yes. Go in the house of worship, fire it up for the Lord.
I see the
Trust Radio 92.9 FM. Gospel Ride. Just a few more days.
After all, this life is over, and my labor here is ended, and I climb upon the mountain top so tall, looking over in that city that my Savior is preparing. Give me grace that I will make it after all.
Turn to the Gospel Ride live on a Saturday night.
After all, this life is over, and my labor here is ended, and I climb up.
Keep as far as possible from spiritual darkness. Just remember that the light of the world is Jesus.
After all, oh yeah, give me grace that I will make it after all.
Yes, just ask the Lord to give you grace.
Give me grace,
strength,
that I will
and endurance that will make it after all. because see, we all need to make it. We all need to make it after all. Some heat, some spiritual heat in the place, because we need to praise the Lord in spirit and in truth. We need to just keep on praising Him. If you're happy and you know it, that the Lord was so good to you this week, and tonight we had such a spiritual uplifting. Say amen to the Lord. Oh, He had made it possible. Hallelujah!
Let the sister say, hallelujah. All the people say, hallelujah. Wave your hand and say, hallelujah. Jump around and say, hallelujah. Shout it out and say, hallelujah. Everybody say, hallelujah. Yes, man. The Spirit of God is in the place, man.
How you say there is something by that?
Getting in a rejoicing mood for worship in the morning. Don't forget to wake up on time to go to worship service. It's good to gather with the brethren to praise the Lord. And sing praises unto His holy name. Because He's worthy to be praised. Give God praise. Give Him glory. Not only in your house, but in the house of worship with the brethren and the saints. And you just don't keep on praising God. Keep on giving Him thanks.
God, I ask for guidance and protection. Shield us from danger.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen, Lord.
in heaven, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your blessing. We thank you, God, for everything. We thank you, Lord, for Choice Radio. Thank you for our listeners. Thank you for each and every one. Most of all, we give you thanks for life. And we ask you, Lord, to help us to continue to serve you, to worship you, because you're mighty and you're worthy to be served. As we go forth, oh God, we ask your blessing on our lives. We ask you to keep us and help us to continue to serve in spirit and in truth. Help us, Lord, in heaven, to show love and to give unto you, oh God, what is due unto you, so others will see your goodness and keep on praising you. And those who haven't come to you as yet, Lord, will come to you through the things that they hear on these airwaves and the things that they hear from your word, from everyone who preaches your gospel. In Jesus' name we ask you to guide and to keep and give traveling mercies and bless your people everywhere. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Blessed are those who have a clean heart. Go and worship the Lamb upon the throne. Oh, yeah. Oh, I believe that I will prosper. And will succeed in all my ways of life. God knows. And no matter how many will come my way, God knows I will make it with my head up high. For the Lord has lifted my eyes unto a higher place, and he said if I believe I live by his grace, yeah, I'm being anointed to prosper.
Yes.
I'm being anointed to rise on high.
I've been anointed to prosper and to rise up in Jesus' name.
Nothing that farm against me will prosper. Take it, brother man, lest you falter. Oh no. Let not the pleasures of this world fool your eyes. Just be kind to one another.
Your fellow man.
Light of the fire shine, for he's seated at the right hand of the Father, making petition for his people there on earth. Yeah, I'm being anointed.
Being anointed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm being anointed to rise on high.
Always. Yes, to rise up. Choice Radio on the air. Choice Radio.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
I'm calling from Kingston, Jamaica, and I'm listening to the program, and I'm enjoying it.
Oh, to God be the glory. To God be the glory. Yes.
Yes. Brother Joy Paul, give me the number.
Brother who?
Try Paul, give me the number.
Okay. Amen.
Yes.
And we are coming on loud and clear out there, right?
Yes. Loud and clear.
Yeah, and you listen the whole program?
Pardon me?
Did you listen the whole program?
No, not all of it.
But you heard enough, right? All right.
Yeah.
So you tune in. Yeah. You know, we have it's ongoing all day, all night, 24/7. But I'm on from 10 to 12 every Saturday night.
Okay.
And I have quite a few listeners in Jamaica too.
Okay.
All right.
Good. Yeah.
So just keep on listening. And
I'd like to send greetings to my aunt over there.
All right.
The Master family.
Okay, greetings is accepted. All right.
Okay.
All right. God bless
you. You take care.
You too. All right. God bless.
Yeah.
Amen.
God bless you too.
Bless you. All right. Yes. You know, oh my God. You know, it's so sweet to know that people all over is listening to the gospel of Christ. And I'm going to just leave this with y'all. Arise, O sleepers. All those who are sleeping and not listening. And spreading the word, just to arise. And give God some praise. As I, you know, as I take my leave to say goodnight. And see you next week, same time, same place. This is Pastor Green with the Gospel Ride, coming to you live on Choice Radio 92.9 FM, streaming live on the internet, westindianpeople.com. And we just praise God for all the listeners in Jamaica, West Indies. And we know all that of people are listening in West Indian Island too. And my friends in England who's listening, God bless you. And to those in Texas, Virginia, Choice Radio is going places with Jesus Christ for his people. And again, I must say out loud, 007, Mr. 007, God bless you, sir. And may heaven smile upon you and cause his countenance to shine upon you and give you more peace. Yes, the peace that passeth all understanding. Yes, be an imitator of God. Yes, and be careful of 2 Peter 2 and 4. The chains of darkness. Break that chain with prayer right now. And with God, I'm going to say good night. God bless you. And worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Because only what you do for Christ will last. This is Pastor Green saying good night. It's your life, your salvation, and your choice. And may God bless you and have a good worship day tomorrow and a blessed week.